Good morning and welcome again. In the last class we considered one dimensional heat conduction in solid cylinder as well as in a circular pipe. So the problem we considered in the last class, that was heat conduction in a solid cylinder, where we considered radial temperature variation, and it is assumed that temperature is not varying along the angular and the axial direction of the solid cylinder. So here I would like to make some corrections in the slide that was presented in the last class. So first thing is, in the dimensionless parameter that we considered, so it was taken that theta equals to t minus t infinity by q triple prime r s square by 4, for which we have written the analytical solution to be theta equal to 1 minus r square plus 2 by Biot number. So this form you will not obtain if you consider theta equal to t minus t infinity by q triple prime r s square by k. So here we needed to consider this 4 here, so that we will obtain the analytical solution of this form, that will be theta equal to 1 minus r square plus 2 by Biot number. So that means here you need to consider theta equals to t minus t infinity divided by q triple prime into r s square by 4 k. So other things will remain as it is. Second thing is that in the governing differential equation in the dimensionless form, on the right hand side, now we will obtain minus 4 instead of minus 1, that we obtained in the last class. Other things remain as it is. Then this is the matrix that we obtained in the last class, and here there is a minor correction in this term, otherwise it is exactly same that was presented in the last class. But actually this will not is the correct matrix. So because of corrections in this form of the dimensionless parameter theta we have used, there will be some corrections here. It will be multiplied by 4 on the right hand side. Secondly, we missed the value of delta r square that needed to be multiplied on the right hand side of the discretized form of the governing differential equation. So as a result, on the right hand side again there will be multiplied by delta r square to the all other terms other than the first equation also. So that's why this is the correct form of the matrix form of the discretized form of the governing differential equations. That means after discretizing the governing differential equations, we will obtain 6 number of equations with 6 number of unknowns, starting from theta equals to 1 up to theta equal to 6. So these 6 equations, when represented in the matrix form, we will obtain this matrix where you are having 36 number of coefficients on this matrix on the left hand side, and you are having 6 number of coefficients for this column matrix that is on the right hand side. At this moment we need to take the help of our program to solve this set of equations to find the unknown values starting from theta 1 up to theta 6. And this is the analytical solution. So we will also go for a comparison of this numerical solution that we will obtain with the analytical solution, so that we can cross verify the accuracy of the numerical solution we have obtained for this particular problem. This shows the two dimensional representation of variation of dimensionless temperature theta along the radial direction of this solid cylinder. So here the domain extends from r equals to 0 at the center up to r is equal to 1 on the outer surface of the solid cylinder. So here on this 2D plot, we have considered r along the x direction and dimensionless theta along the y direction. This curve represents the value obtained from the analytical solution, and this dots we obtained from the numerical solution. So for the analytical solution, this equation have been used here. So here it can see there is a considerable accuracy obtained in the numerical solution because they are matching perfectly with the analytical solution for which we have used this expression. And this shows the temperature contour diagram on the cross sectional face of the solid cylinder. So here it can be seen, it is maximum temperature at the center and minimum temperature on the outer surface. So this is the construction of this contour have been done using the information that is given here on this two dimensional plot. So here you see we have considered the grids for construction of this temperature contour as shown here in this case. So here in actual case we consider 6 number of grid points along the radial direction. So one point is positioned at the center and another point positioned on the outer surface, and in between them there were 4 grid points, so that we divided the radial dimension into 5 equal number of divisions. From the value of temperature at this 6 number of grid points, we obtained this temperature contour diagram. For construction of this temperature contour diagram, you have to present the information in the form of mesh as shown here in this case, from which we are able to construct this temperature contour diagram. And this shows the 3-dimensional view of the temperature contour diagram. So here the same information had been used, only thing is that here we have taken the values remaining constant along the z direction, that is along the axis of this cylinder, which can be seen here in this 3D temperature contour diagram. So here you see the grids have been considered here in the radial direction from the center up to the outer surface, and the information we have at these grid points along one radial line is used to construct this 3D diagram. So first thing is that here we consider these temperature values remain constant as we move in the angular direction, and also this temperature remains constant as we move along the axial direction of this cylinder. So for this purpose, this is the grid considered for reconstruction of this temperature contour. Next, we will consider 2-dimensional heat conduction in a insulated tip pin fin. So here it is a circular fin attached to the surface which is relatively at a higher temperature. So here our objective will be to find out variation of the temperature along the radial as well as along the axial direction of the fin. So here we consider the temperature remains constant in the angular direction of this fin here. So the base of the fin is given to be constant, that is 100 degree centigrade, and there is a heat transfer from this outer surface to the ambient fluid by means of convection, for which heat transfer coefficient is given along with the temperature of this ambient fluid is given. The conductivity of this fin material is also given along with the dimensions of this fin will be given to us, that means the length and the diameter of this fin. So here the governing differential equation for this case will be dou square T by dou r square plus 1 by r dou T by dou r, this will be plus dou square T by dou z square equals to 0. So here in this equation, this first term, that is dou square T by dou z square, represents variation of temperature T along the axis of this fin. Then the second next to 2 terms represent the variation of temperature T along the radial direction of this pin fin. So here if you will closely observe, there exists a symmetry by considering a transverse section about this fin, and again you consider half of this transverse section, then we will obtain this geometrical 2D shape. So here we can consider this to be the z direction, that is along the axis of this fin, and this is the radial direction, and this line represents the center of this fin here. So these 2 dimensions will represent here, one is this total radius of this fin, that is rs. So here it starts from r is equal to 0 up to r is equal to rs here. Similarly along the z direction, it will start from z is equal to 0, again it will go to z is equal to l, because l is the length of this fin here. Then we will go for writing the boundary conditions. So here we will have 4 number of boundaries. So first one will be on this face here, that represents the base of the fin, that is here. So where temperature is considered to be constant, let it be equal to TB. So mathematically you can write down z is equal to 0, T is equal to TB here. Then we will write down boundary condition on the other face, that is at the this face here, which represents the tip of this fin, which is given to be insulated here. So mathematically you can write down this to be at z is equal to L, dou T by dou z is equal to 0 here. Then the third boundary will be here, which corresponds to r is equals to 0, which represents the center line, that means line of symmetry. So this again you can write down mathematically, r is equal to 0, dou t by dou r equals to 0. Then we will have the other boundary, that is at the top here in this diagram. So this represents the outer surface from which heat transfer by means of convection takes place to the ambient fluid. So from energy balance we can write down a condition mathematically, that is at r is equal to rs, that is here along this surface, minus k dt by dr equals to h into t minus t infinity. That means this represents heat going towards this surface by means of conduction is equal to heat going away from the surface by means of convection. So next we will consider dimensionless parameters to solve this problem. So first with the help of this dimensionless parameters we will rewrite these 5 equations in the dimensionless form, then we will start solving numerically. So here the dimensionless parameter, that is theta, is taken, that is for temperature, is defined as T minus T infinity by T B minus T infinity. Then R is defined as R by R S, so that the domain will extend from capital R is equal to 0 here up to capital R is equal to 1 here, because we are dividing by R S. Then Z is defined as, capital Z is defined as Z by R S, so that here the domain will extend from capital Z is equal to 0 to capital Z is equal to L by R S. Then this byte number is defined as H into R S by K. So using these dimensionless parameters, we can rewrite these 5 equations in the dimensionless form. So first the governing differential equation, which will become dou square theta by dou Z square plus dou square theta by dou R square plus 1 by R dou theta by dou R equals to 0. Then the boundary condition, this one in the dimensionless form will be capital Z is equal to 0, theta equals to 1. Second boundary condition will become capital Z is equal to alpha, where this alpha is defined as the ratio of length of this fin to the radius of this fin, that is L by R S. So when Z is equal to L, Z equal to L, we get dou theta by dou Z equals to 0. Then at R is equals to 0, we will have again obtain from this equation dou theta by dou R equals to 0. Then here on this surface, that is capital R is equal to 1, we will get dou theta by dou R plus byte number into theta equals to 0, where byte number is defined like this. So next we will go for the discretization of the governing differential equation and the boundary conditions. So here this is our geometry, and here in the dimensionless form, along this edge theta equals to 1 here, which represent the constant temperature along the base. Again here on this surface it is dou theta by dou R plus byte number into theta equal to 0, which represents heat transfer by convection. Here on the tip it is insulated, here also on the line of symmetry or plane of symmetry it is again insulated. Let's say we will consider the grid arrangements as shown here in this diagram by considering 5 equal divisions along the axial direction and 3 equal divisions along the radial direction. So here we will consider the variable I to denote the position of the grid along the axial direction Z, and the variable J to denote the position of the grid along the radial direction here. So that I will extend from 1 up to 6 here, and J will extend from 1 up to 4 here. So in total we obtained here 6 into 4, 24 number of grid points. Out of 24 number of grid points, these 4 grid points, which is at the base of this fin, have been represented in a separate color to represent a constant temperature value, which is also known to us. That is in the dimensionless form, theta is equal to 1 here along this line. That is at these 4 grid points, theta is given to be 1. And at this moment, our objective will be to find out the value of theta at the remaining values of the remaining position of the grid point, that is along the 5 into 4, 20 number of grid points. So finally we will obtain temperature theta value at this 20 number of grid points, and this information can be used further to reconstruct a temperature contour plot or any other information that have been asked for. So here let's say first we go for writing the discretization of the boundary conditions. First we will consider this boundary, which corresponds to I is equals to 1, and well J varies from 1 up to 4 here. So here Mathematically it is given that theta is equal to 1. So discretization of theta will become theta I comma j is 1 here. So here we can take the value of I 1 and j values 4 times, starting from 1 up to 4 here. So that from here you will obtain 4 expressions. So you will get theta 1 comma 1 equals to 1, theta 1 comma 2 equals to 1, theta 1 comma 3 equals to 1, theta 1 comma 4 equals to 1 here. And these expressions we will use later on while discretizing the governing differential equation. Next you will go for this boundary which represents the tip of the fin, where the value of I is equal to 6 and j value varying from 1 to 4 here. So here it is given z is equal to alpha dou theta by dou z is 0 here. So discretization of dou theta by dou z, that can be written using central difference scheme, theta I plus 1 comma j minus theta I minus 1 comma j divided by 2 delta z, that is equal to 0. So from this expression we will obtain theta I plus 1 comma j equals to theta I minus 1 comma j. So using the value of I equal to 6 and j equal to 1 to 4, we will obtain these 4 expressions, that is theta 7 1 will be equal to theta 5 1. Similarly, theta 7 2 will be equal to theta 5 2, theta 7 3 equals to theta 5 3, theta 7 4 equals to theta 5 4. So that means here you have to consider imaginary grids at a value of I equal to 7, which will be positioned here on the right hand side of this tip of this fin. And these values also we will use later on while we discretize the governing differential equation. Then we will go for the third boundary, which corresponds to the line of symmetry, where the value of j equals to constant, that is 1, and the value of I varying from 1 up to 6 here. So here at this plane, at this boundary, it is dou theta by dou r equals to 0, so which can be discretized using the central difference scheme and can be written as theta I comma j plus 1 equals to theta I comma j minus 1 divided by 2 delta r, that is equals to 0. So from here we will obtain theta I comma j minus 1 equals to theta I comma j plus 1, and considering the value of j equals to 1, you will obtain theta I comma 0 equals to theta I comma 2 for different values of I starting from 1 up to 6 here. So using these 6 values of I, you will obtain 6 expressions, like theta 1 0 equals to, you will obtain theta 1 2, theta 2 0 equal to theta 1 2, like this you obtain 6 expressions up to theta 6 0 equals to theta 6 2 here. These 6 expressions again will be used while we discretize the governing differential equation later on. Then we will go for the upper boundary, that is here, which corresponds to j is equal to constant value 4 and I is varying from 1 to 6 here. So for this boundary condition number 4, here it is, you get dou theta by dou r plus bat number theta equals to 0. So dou theta by dou r in the discretized form can be written as theta I comma j plus 1 minus theta I comma j divided by 2 delta r plus bat number into discretization of theta will be theta I comma j equals to 0. So now we can simplify this expression by multiplying 2 delta r and taking this term to the other side. So you will obtain theta I comma j plus 1 equals to theta I comma j minus 1 plus 2 delta r bat number into theta I j, and here j is equal to 4 and I is varying from 1 to 6. So when you consider j is equal to 4, we will obtain here theta I comma 5 equals to theta I comma 3 minus 2 delta r bat number into theta I comma 4. So this is true for different value of I starting from 1 to 6 here. So we need to consider the 6 values of I here so that we will obtain 6 expressions. So here when you consider I is equals to 1 here, you will obtain here theta 1 comma 5 equals to theta 1 comma 3 minus 2 delta r bat number into theta 1 comma 4. Similarly, we will obtain an expression for theta 2 comma 5, theta 3 comma 5, theta 4 comma 5, theta 5 comma 5 and theta 6 comma 5. So values of this theta starting from theta 1 comma 5 up to theta 6 comma 5 will be used later on while you discretize the governing differential equation. Next we will go for discretization of the governing differential equation, which is valid over the full domain. So this is the discretized governing differential equation. So here it can be observed that for j is equal to 1, which corresponds to the center of this fin, that is r is equal to 0. So for which this third term in this governing differential equation, which is 1 by r into dou theta by dou r. So this value, when r is equal to 0, that is at the center of this fin, comes out to be indeterminate because it is in the form of 0 by 0. Therefore, this form of the governing differential equation cannot be applied at the center of the fin, that is at r is equal to 0 or j equals to 1. So that's why we can use the L-Hospital rule to find out an alternate form for this expression, which can be substituted here in this governing differential equation, so that we will obtain another form of the governing differential equation that will be applicable for j is equal to 1 or r is equal to 0. And this form of the governing differential equation will be applicable at all other values of j, starting from j is equal to 2 up to j is equal to 4, which covers the full domain when we consider the value of I starting from 1 up to I equal to 6 here. So when you adopt L-Hospital rule, so this expression we will obtain as dou square theta by dou r square. That means the third term in the governing differential equation can be replaced by this expression, so, and further simplified, that will represent the governing differential equation when j equals to 1 here. So for different value of I starting from 1 to 6, when j is equals to 1, it represents this line, or you say this is the center of the fin where r is equals to 0. So for which, when you put this expression for the third term here in this governing differential equation, so you obtained here dou square theta by dou z square, plus you are getting dou square theta by dou r square plus dou square theta by dou r square. This term comes here, so that you obtained here 2 dou square theta by dou r square, that is equal to 0. So this is the governing differential equation for j is equal to 1 or r is equal to 0. So this can be discretized using the central difference scheme. So for the first term, dou square theta by dou z square, we can write it like this: theta I minus 1 comma j minus 2 theta I comma j plus theta I plus 1 comma j divided by delta z square plus 2 into discretization of dou square theta by dou r square. That can be written as theta I comma j minus 1 minus 2 theta I comma j plus theta I comma j plus 1 divided by delta r square, that is equals to 0. So this represents the discretized form of the governing differential equation, which is true at the center of this fin, that is at r is equal to 0 or j is equal to 1. Next, we will write the governing discretized form of the governing differential equation, which is true at all other points in the domain of the problem. So here, for j is equal to 2 to 4, we will use this form of the governing differential equation. This is written again here, and now we will go for the discretization of this governing differential equation. So the first term will be same as the first term here, so that's why discretization will be same as this term. So we just rewrite it exactly. That is theta I minus 1 comma j minus 2 theta I j plus theta I plus 1 j divided by delta z square. Then the next term is dou square theta by dou r square. So you will get here theta I comma j minus 1 minus 2 theta I j plus theta I comma j plus 1 divided by delta r square. Then third term we are getting plus 1 by r dou theta by dou r. So you are getting 1 by r I j, discretization of r will be r I j. Then dou theta by dou r can be discretized in the using central difference scheme and can be written as theta I comma j plus 1 minus theta I comma j minus 1 divided by 2 delta r, that is equals to 0. So here in this diagram, this shows the grid spacing along the z direction and this shows the grid spacing along the radial direction. So these two are represented delta z and delta r here. So this delta z can be represented as alpha divided by m, where m is the total number of divisions we have considered along the z direction, and alpha is the total domain length along the z direction. Similarly, this delta r is the grid spacing along the y direction, which is equals to total number of domain dimensions along the y direction divided by total number of divisions, which is equals to n here. And this dimension length in the dimensionless form, which comes out to be 1 here. So that's why we are getting delta r is equal to 1 by n here. Then let's say we write down beta, that is equal to delta z by delta r, which represent the aspect ratio of this geometrical grid we obtained here. So first we will consider for j is equals to 1, that is at this 5 grid points, because here already you know the temperature corresponding to I is equal to 1 at this 4 grid point. That's why we will rewrite the discretized form of the governing differential equation at the remaining 20 number of grid points only. So in the first step we will consider the discretized form of the governing differential equation along this 5 number of grid points corresponding to I is equal to 2 to 6, where j is equal to 1, that is constant here. So corresponding to j is equal to 1, this is the discretized form of the governing differential equation that have been taken from the previous slide. Now we need to further simplify it and rewrite this equation for every value of I starting from 2 up to I is equal to 6 here. So here you can multiply this expression by delta z square, so that here first term you will obtain here theta I minus 1 comma j minus 2 theta I j plus theta I plus 1 comma j, plus you will get 2 into delta z square by delta r square. This delta z by delta r represent a beta, that's why here you will obtain 2 beta square into the term here you will obtain, that is theta I comma j minus 1 minus 2 theta I j plus theta I comma j plus 1, in that is equals to 0 on the right hand side. Then here you are having theta I minus 1 comma j, and here you are having minus 2 theta I j, there is again 2 theta I j, so they will combine here. So you will get this term minus 2 into 1 plus 2 beta square theta I j, because here you are having a minus 2, here you are having a minus 2 multiplied by 2 beta square. So you are getting here minus 4 beta square. So you get this equation here. So in total you are getting 5 terms on the left hand side here in this expression. Then here we can consider the value of j is equals to 1. So wherever you are having j, that we will replace it by 1. So that you will obtain here 2 beta square into theta I comma j 1 minus 1 is 0 plus theta I minus 1 comma j is 1 minus 2 into 1 plus 2 beta square into theta I comma j is 1 here plus theta I plus 1 comma 1 plus 2 beta square theta I comma j plus 1, j is 1 here, 1 plus 1 is 2 here. So you will get theta I comma 2 is equal, finally that is equal to 0 on the right hand side. Then we will rewrite this equation 5 times for different value of I starting from 2 up to 6 here. So when you consider I is equals to 2 here, in this expression you put it here, so you obtain 2 beta square into theta 2 comma 0 plus theta 2 minus 1 is 1 comma 1 minus 2 into 1 plus 2 beta square theta 2 comma 1 here plus theta 2 plus 1, that is 3 comma 1 plus 2 beta square theta 2 comma 2 here, that is equals to 0. Similarly, you can write it for I is equals to 2, then I is equal to 3, then I is equal to 4, then I is equal to 5, and I is equal to 6 here. So you obtained here 5 number of equations here. Then here you can see we are having theta 2 comma 0, theta 3 0, 4 0, 5 0, and theta 6 0. So this 0 represents your the value of j, that is equal to 0, but the value of j starts from 1 here only. That means this represents the value of temperature theta at this imaginary grid points, which will be positioned here. So for this values we have already derived expressions while we discretize the governing differential equation. So we need to substitute them here for these 5 terms. Then again this theta 1 comma 1, it represents the value of theta here, which is equal to theta, that is 1 here. So we know this. So this also we need to be replaced here. Then here we are having a term theta 7 comma 1 here. So here this represents theta 6 comma 1. So you will get a grid point somewhere here, which will be denoted as 7 comma 1, which is again a imaginary grid point. And for this grid temperature, for this value grid point also we derived an expression earlier. So that also we need to use it here. So by substituting this 7 values of theta, we will rewrite this equations again here. Here theta 2 comma 0 becomes theta 2 comma 2, theta 3 comma 0 becomes 3 comma 2, like this we replace this 5 values of theta. And here theta 1 comma 1 is 1 here, then theta 7 comma 1 already we got, which comes out to be theta 5 comma 1 here. So we have rewritten this 5 equations. Now you can further simplify this 5 equations. So here in the first equation it can be seen we are having 2 beta square theta 2 2, there is again 2 beta square theta 2 2. So they can be combined here, so you will get 4 beta square theta 2 2. Then this 1, it will go to the other side, so you will get a minus 1 here. Then remaining here, you will get 2 into 1 plus 2 beta square into theta 2 1. Then you are getting theta 3 1 here. So similarly, you rewrite this 5 equations. So these are the 5 equations we have obtained here. So now, at this moment, we need to renumber this position, grid positions by a single number system starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this, as shown here in this diagram. So this represents the grid numbering in the I, j system, and this shows the grid numbering in the single number system. Starting from grid number 1, it goes up to 5 here, then it starts from 6 up to 10 here, again starts from 11, it goes up to 15 here. Then it starts from 16 here, it goes up to 20 here. So this indicates the number for the 20 number of grid points where the temperature theta is not known to us. And our objective now is to find out the temperature at this 20 number of grid points here. So these 5 equations need to be rewritten by converting this theta I, j to into a theta single number system here. So this can be rewritten here. So you will getting here minus 2 into 1 plus 2 beta square into theta 2 comma 1 here. So 2 comma 1 represents this point. So this point here represented as 1 here. So we are getting here theta 1 plus theta 3 comma 1. So 3 comma 1 represents this point, which is here is a number is 2 here. So we are getting plus theta 2 plus 4 beta square into theta 2 comma 2. So theta 2 comma 2 represents this point, which is here represented as 6 here. So we are getting 4 beta square into theta 6. That is equal to minus 1 on the right hand side. So like this, you rewrite the remaining 4 equations. So this will be the remaining 4 equations here. So that means here we obtained 5 equations involving the unknown starting from I is equal to 1, which is going up to I is equal to 10 here. Later on we will see, in total we will obtain 20 equations with 20 unknowns here. So out of the 20 equations, we obtained now the first 5 equations corresponding to the values of the grid number starting from 1 up to 5, for which we obtained these equations. Next, we will move to the remaining grid points for which the values of j is 2 to 4 and the value of I is varying from 2 to 6 here. So that means here we are having in total 5 into 3, 15 number of grid points. So for this 15 number of grid points, this is the discretized form of the governing differential equation, which we had already written. From there, we have taken it directly. Now, we need to further simplify this and rewrite this equation at this 15 number of grid points. So, here we will see the expression Rij will be equal to j minus 1 into delta R. So, here in this case, you consider this is the center of this fin here, then you are moving along this radial direction. Let us say up to this grid point. So, here from this point up to this point, which represent this grid spacing, that is equal to the value of the radius at this grid point, which is equal to delta r, that means 1 delta r. So, if you use this expression, if you put j is equal to 2 here, so we are getting 2 minus 1, that is 1 into delta r is delta r here. Similarly, if you are here, then from this point up to this point, that is from here to here, this is the radial distance, which will be j is equal to, you put 3 here, 3 minus 1 is 2 into delta r, that is 2 delta r. So, this is delta r plus this is delta r. Like this, you will obtain the values of Rij using this expression, and this need to be used here. So, you multiply this expression by delta z square for further simplification. So, you will obtain this first 3 terms here, plus you will get here delta z square by delta r square. So, delta z by delta r we earlier defined as beta. So, we will get beta square into these 3 terms here, that will be inside the bracket, plus here you are getting delta z square divided by, so this at the bottom you will getting j minus 1 into delta r into 2 delta r. So, at the bottom you will get 2 into j minus 1 into delta r square. So, here you are having 1 by 2 into j minus 1, then you will obtain delta z square by delta r square, which is represented beta square multiplied by these 2 terms in the inside the bracket here. So, this can be further simplified and it can be rewritten as in this form. So here you see you are having a minus 2 theta I comma j, then here again you are having a minus 2 theta I comma j multiplied by beta square. So they are combined here, so that you will get, you are getting here minus 2 into 1 plus beta square theta I comma j, and other terms are simplified and it is rewritten. So finally you obtain this expression. So this expression can be used again to rewrite it at this 15 number of grid points for j is equal to 2 to 4 and I is equal to again 2 to 6 here. So from this we will obtain 15 number of equations. So this is the equation we obtained. First we will consider j is equal to 2 and you rewrite this equation here. So once you take j is equal to 2, you will get, you will obtain here 2 into 2 4 minus 3 is 1 divided by 2 into 2 is 4 minus 2 is 2. So you are getting beta square by 2 into theta I comma j is 2 here, 2 minus 1 is 1. So theta 1 comma 1 plus theta I minus 1 comma 2 minus 2 into 1 plus beta square theta I comma j is 2 here, theta 1 I comma 2 plus theta I plus 1 comma j comes to be 2 here plus beta square into, you will get here theta I comma j plus 1, j is 2 here, so you will getting theta I comma 3 multiplied by this term. When you put j is equal to 2, you obtain it is 3 by 2 here. So this equation is applicable for value of j equal to 2. So that is corresponding to this value of j. So starting from I is equal to 2 up to I is equal to 6 here. So we will rewrite this equation again at this 5 grid points, starting from I is equal to 2 up to I is equal to 6 at this 5 grid points. So first you take I is equal to 2 here in this expression. So you get beta square by 2, that is 0.5 beta square into theta 2 comma 1 minus theta 2 minus 1, it is 1 comma 2 minus 2 into 1 plus beta square theta 2 comma 2 plus theta 2 plus 1 3 comma 2 plus 3 by 2 beta square into theta 2 comma 3, that is equal to 0. So like this we will rewrite this equation for remaining 4 values of I, starting from I is equal to 3, I equals to 4, I equals to 5 and I equals to 6 here. So we obtained this 5 equations here, and in this case you see you are having theta 1 comma 2 here. So it is, this is the point represented as 1 comma 2. Here we know the value of temperature, that is theta is equal to 1. So we will replace this by 1 here. Then here we are having a theta 7 comma 2 here. So you will obtain this 7 comma 2, this point will come somewhere here, which is again imaginary grid point, for which you obtain expression which is equal to theta 5 comma 2. So this to be replaced by theta 5 comma 2, and this is to be written to be equal to 1 here. And this 1 you will obtain here, it can be taken to the other side, so you will get here minus 1. So you obtain minus 1 here. Then again this theta 7 2 is equal to theta 5 comma 2, again there is a theta 5 comma 2, they will come in here. So it will, you will get here 2 theta 5 comma 2. So here we obtain 2 theta 5 comma 2, and the remaining 3 equations that will remain as it is. Then we will rewrite this 5 equations in the single number system now. So the first equation, it is 0.5 beta square into theta 2 comma 1. So this represents theta 2 comma 1, which is equal to theta 1 here. So we are writing here theta 1 minus 2 into 1 plus beta square into theta 2 comma 2 represent this point, which is here number is 6 here. So we will get for this one theta 6 here. Then you are getting theta 3 comma 2. So this represents theta 3 comma 2, which is single number is 7 here. So this becomes your theta 7 plus 1.5 beta square into theta 2 comma 3. So 2 comma 3 is this point which represents number 11 here. So you are getting 1.5 beta square into theta 11, that is equal to minus 1. So like this we need to write the remaining 4 equations in the single number system. So these are the remaining 4 values, remaining 4 equations we obtained here. So now here you are having 5 more equations here. So that means till so far we obtained 10 equations, 5 equations corresponding to these 5 grid points, and these are the 5 equations we obtained corresponding to these 5 grid points here, corresponding to j is equal to 2. Next we will move for j is equal to 3. So this is the discretized form of the governing differential equation applicable for j is equal to 2 to 4. Now here we will consider j is equal to 3 here. Again we rewrite this so that this the equation we will obtain will be applicable for these 5 grid points for j is equal to 3 and I is equal to 2 to 6 here along this line. So when you put j is equal to 3, we will obtain this equation here, beta square into 3 by 4, you will get this term, into theta I comma j minus 1, that is 3 minus 1 is 2 here, you will get here theta I comma 2 plus theta I minus 1 comma j, j is 3, here 3, like this you will obtain this equation. Now we need to rewrite this equation for the different value of I, starting from I is equal to 2 up to I is equal to 5 here, I equal to 6 here. So, when you take I equals to 2 here in this expression, you will obtain it is 3 by 4, that is 0.75 beta square into theta 2 comma 2 minus theta 2 minus 1, that is 1 comma 3 minus 2 into 1 plus beta square theta I is 2 comma 3 plus theta I plus 1, that is 2 plus 1, that is 3 comma 3 plus 5 by 4, that is 1.25 beta square into theta 2 comma 4, that is equals to 0. So, similarly, we will rewrite this equation for I is equal to 3, I is equal to 4, I is equal to 5, then I is equal to 6 here. So, here in these 5 equations, we need to further simplify this one by considering this value of theta 1 3 and theta 7 3. So, theta 1 3 represents the value of temperature here at this point, where the theta is equal to 1 here. So, we will replace it by 1, and this one will go to the other side, that will become minus 1. Then theta 7 5 represents here, and the value of theta 7 3 represents the value of temperature somewhere here at this grid point, which is the imaginary grid point, for which we have already derived an expression which is equal to theta 5 comma 3. So, we will replace this term by theta 5 comma 3, there is another theta 5 comma 3. So, they will combine together, it will form 2 theta 5 comma 3, and this minus, when you replace it by minus 1, this will go to the other side, it will become minus 1. And the remaining 3 equations we will write as it is. So, finally, you obtain this 5 equations. Here we are getting on the right hand side minus 1, here you obtain 2 theta 5 3, other things remain as it is. Then we need to rewrite them in the single number system in reference to this diagram here. So, here you obtain 0.75 beta square into theta 2 comma 2. So, this is the point where it is number is 6 here, so we are getting theta 6. Plus you minus you are getting 2 into 1 plus beta square into theta 2 comma 3. Theta 2 comma 3 represents this point where it is number is 11. So, we are getting here this term is replaced as theta 11 plus theta 3 comma 3 represents this point here, which is equal to number 12 here. So, we are getting for this term we are getting theta 12 plus 1.25 beta square into theta 2 comma 4. This represents this point where the number is 16 here. So, you are getting here theta 16, that is equal to minus 1. Like this you rewrite the remaining 4 equations in the single number system in reference to these 2 diagrams here. So, now we obtained 5 more equations. So, corresponding to this j is equal to 3 and I is equal to 2 to 6 here. So, till so far we obtained 15 number of equations. Next we will shift to the last row of grid points corresponding to j is equal to 4 here. So, corresponding to j is equal to 4, we can further simplify this equation by putting j is equal to 4 here. So, we will obtain this expression, this you will get 5 by 6 into beta square into theta I comma j minus 1, and when j is equal to 4 here, you are getting theta 4 minus 1 is 3 here, so theta I comma 3, like this we will obtain the other terms in this equation. And this need to be rewritten at the grid points, starting from I is equal to 2 up to I is equal to 6 here. So, first considering I is equal to 2 here in this expression, you will get 5 by 6 into beta square theta 2 comma 3 plus theta 2 minus 1, it is 1 comma 4 minus 2 into 1 plus beta square theta 2 comma 4 plus theta 2 plus 1 3 comma 4 plus 7 by 6 beta square theta 2 comma 5, that is equal to 0. Similarly, we will rewrite this equation for the remaining value of I. For I is equal to 3, you will obtain this equation. Next for I is equal to 4, next for I equals to 5, next for I equals to 6 here. So, now we obtained 5 more equations corresponding to the value of j equal to 4 and I is equal to 2 to 6 here. So, at this moment now we have in total 20 number of equations and 20 number of unknowns, starting from theta 1 up to theta 20, that is value of temperature at this 20 number of grid points, where it is the unknown value. So, we need to solve these 20 equations having 20 unknowns and find the value of temperature at this grid points, which can be done with the help of the computer program that we have already having. So, now here before we go for this one, we need to further simplify these 5 equations. So, here theta 1 4 represents the temperature here, where theta is equals to 1 here. So, you need to replace it by 1 and this will go to the other side, it will be minus 1. Then theta 7 4 represent the grid point here, which is a imaginary grid point for which you have already got the expression, which is equal to theta 5 comma 4. So, there is a theta 5 4, there is another theta 5 4. So, they will combine, so they will form 2 theta 5 4. Then here we are having this theta 2 comma 5 here. So, that represents a imaginary grid point here, theta 3 5 another imaginary grid point here, like this you have another row of imaginary grid points for which already we derived the expressions. So, theta 2 comma 5 equal to theta 2, already we have got one expression that we need to replace it here. So, if you recall, for theta 2 comma 5 we obtained one expression, theta 2 comma 3 minus 2 delta r into Biot number into theta 2 comma 4. So, this term to be replaced by these two terms here. Similarly, for the remaining four equations also we have to rewrite it here. So, we need to rewrite these five equations. So, these are the five equations we will obtain here. So, here we obtained minus 1, for this term this becomes 1 and this go to other side you got minus 1. Again here you are getting theta 5 4, theta 5 4 you got here 2 theta 5 4 and this theta 2 comma 5 up to theta 6 comma 5, they have been replaced by this 5 terms given here in the bracket here. So, this is the first one, second one, third one, fourth one and fifth one. Next we need to rewrite them in a single number system and before that one we will further simplify this equation here. So, you can see here you are having a theta 2 comma 3, there is again theta 2 comma 3 is there. So, it is 7 by 6 beta square theta 2 comma 3, 7 by 6, it is 5 by 6 beta square theta 2 comma 3, 7 by 6 beta square theta 2 comma 3. So, they will combine that forms here 2 beta square theta 2 comma 3. Like this, you further simplify. So, this is the simplified form of this 5 equations listed here. So, these are the 5 equations we obtained here. Now, we need to convert these 5 equations into single number system. For example, you see 2 beta square into theta 2 comma 3, 2 comma 3 represent this point which is equal to 11 here. So, this will become theta 11, theta 2 comma 4, this will become theta 16, then theta 3 comma 4, this will become here theta 17. So, you can see theta 11, theta 16, theta 17. Like this, the remaining 4 equations are also again rewritten here. So, this is the final 5 set of equations which completes the in total 20 number of equations for this 20 grid points. So, from this 20 equations and 20 unknowns, we will obtain these values of theta at this grid points by using the computer program. So, first we will list out these 20 equations in the matrix form. So, this represents a matrix which represents the coefficient values on the left hand side. So, here you can see the equations are complicated. So, to represent in compact form, these are the symbols have been used for writing the matrix, coefficient matrix on the left hand side. So, here you see, here we are being y, a, b, c, d, e, f, g and h. So, for which these are the expressions as a function of beta and a to g and y is function of beta only, while h is function of beta in addition to the Biot number here. So, to further simplify this one, we need to know the value of beta and the Biot number, so that we can solve this set of equations. So, here if you closely observe, here we are being 20 rows. So, this first 5 row represent the equations we obtained the grid point number 1 to 5 here, or you say I is equal to 2 to 6 corresponding to j is equal to 1. Then remaining 5 rows represent the equations we obtained by taking the value of j equal to 2 while I is equal to 2 to 6 here. Then third 5 set of rows represents the equations that we obtained from j is equal to 3 while I is equal to 2 to 6 here. Then the remaining 5 set of equations we obtained when we consider j is equal to 4 and I is equal to 2 to 6 here. Then you can go for another observation. This is the elements along the main diagonal and then you have two, one is diagonal slightly just above this one, another diagonal just below this one. So, along which you are having the values. Then you can see, then along this line also you are having the values and along this line also you are having the values. And all other remaining coefficients values are 0 values. So, here also you can observe, so here there is a pattern is coming out. So, this is because of the nature of the problem and the nature of the boundary conditions that can be closely observed, and this will help us to formulate this coefficient matrix when you consider finer meshing or more number of divisions both along the radial and the axial direction of the fin here. Then we can go for calculating the values of this coefficient values. So, this beta is defined as delta z by delta r. For the values of the dimension and other information given to you, you will obtain this beta comes out to be 1 and this Biot number also comes out to be equals to 1 here. So, you can use these values of beta and Biot number to calculate the values of this symbols we have used here, starting from a up to h and the values of y. So, here the value of y comes out to be minus 6, a comes out to be 4, b is 0.5, c is minus 4, d comes out to 1.5, e is 0.75, f is 1.25, g comes out to be 2 and h comes out to be minus 4.8. Then this represents the values of the coefficients of the set of simultaneous 20 number of simultaneous equations having 20 unknowns. And these 20 equations can be solved with the help of the program, and we will obtain the temperature at these 20 grid points starting from number 1 up to number 20, and along with the value of theta at this 4 grid point, that is at the base of the fin where theta is given to be 1, we can go for reconstructing the temperature contour. So, this is your fin here, and this is the computational domain we have taken, half of the transverse section of this fin passing through the center. So, this represents the temperature contour for this computational domain that was under consideration. So, here it can be seen along this boundary here the temperature is constant, which corresponds to theta is equals to 1 here. So, which we have given as part of the boundary condition, and we calculate the temperature at the other locations. So, this is the grid which was considered by considering 5 equal divisions along the axial direction and 3 equal divisions along the radial direction, and these were the grid points. These 4 grid points represented here in this blue color, where temperature, that is theta, was known to us, that is a constant value of 1, and this 20 number of grid points represented by the red dot, where temperature theta was unknown to us, and we calculated them. And using this value of 6 into 4, 24 temperature at this 24 grid points, we reconstructed this temperature contour. But here it can be seen this isotherm's lines are not smooth curves because of coarse mesh we have considered here. So, if you consider finer mesh by taking more number of divisions both along the radial and the axial direction, we will be able to obtain a smooth curve for this isotherm curves. Then we will go for constructing a three-dimensional temperature contour for this geometry that was under consideration. So, here it shows the temperature contour in three-dimensional form. So, this represents the base of this fin. Here it shows the half of the fin that we have taken by considering a transverse section of this fin here. So, here it can be seen this base is at a constant temperature of dimensionless form 1 here. Then gradually, as you are moving in the axial direction towards the tip, the temperature is decreasing. Also, if you are moving towards the radially, you can see the temperature also changing here, and there is a heat transfer going from the surface by means of convection. So, this is one view of the temperature contour in 3D, and this shows the another view of the same temperature contour in the three-dimensional. So, here at the top also you can see here, this isotherm curves are circular in nature and they are parallel to the each other here, that is parallel to the outer surface here. Next we will go see, this is the another view of this three-dimensional temperature contour, along with this is the another view. So, here it shows variation of temperature as we move in the along the axis, and this shows the temperature contour on the outer surface. Then we consider another view of the 3D temperature contour. And all these views have been constructed by considering three-dimensional mesh, which is shown here in this diagram. So, basically you obtained the temperature at this 20 number of, 24 number of, by taking the value of theta at this 24 number of grid points, out of which temperature at 4 number of grid points were known to us. That means you see these are the grid points here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 6 into 4, 24. So, from this value of 24 grid points, we reconstructed this 3 dimensional temperature contour by considering the temperature remains constant along the theta direction here. So, all the students are encouraged to reconstruct this temperature contour diagrams from the numerical solution you will obtain using your own program. So, please do it yourself and you check it here. Okay, thank you. We will continue in the next class.